Welcome back, everybody, here to your broadcast of the 4PL Cup. That's right, we've actually had ourselves like a week off with this, but doesn't matter, we're back here again, and we're going to be doing one of our matches from, let me even just show you on the grid. You know what, sometimes explanations visually are the best ways of doing it. So we're looking right now at our last round, so the round of 32, before we hit our quarterfinals. This is where our quarterfinal slot is waiting for us. IC Cup is the first team on the list, coming down through 113th in their position, and then we have Game at Uni also managing to fight their way through mostly unknown teams in these early rounds. And of course, this is the reason why we jump ourselves in at this point of the competition, because basically we're into the known teams, or at least the semi-known teams. IC Cup used to be a very, very big name when it came to Dota, mainly because PGG was the main man behind it. And then it changed around. This is also a little bit more of a combination of a couple of other players and not a full IC Cup, hence they don't have the team profile name on for this game. But Nubik, as well as No Fear, are from IC Cup. Sunlight, Must Rock, and Talent 2 Berrarido. I have no idea. We're going to call him Talent. Is the last player coming out from IC Cup. A little bit more of a couple of known names coming out from Gamer Uni. So Pylai Dai, Nessel, Rocketman, Benser, as well as Riku. That is their full lineup for Gamer Uni. That's the university lineup, because Gamer Uni, they've got multiple different lineups, Gamer Uni. Actually, I cannot remember off the top of my head their previous lineup they had. But yeah, at the end of the day, it's still Gamer Uni going up against IC Cup. And that's coming up right now. So, we're going to have our bans out so far. Wisp, as well as Mag, as well as Batrider and Nyx being the first set of bans, allowing Coddle through. Darkseer also, he got through earlier tonight, but he got a little bit ignored. But he does get picked up there in that secondary position with the Shadow Demon pickup. And then Bane and Gyro come out. They're probably expecting a Nakes pickup to come out from GU, but he was also banned out. So we get Control, we get Keep It Light, we get Gyro. So we got already a lot of heroes we've seen earlier today, apart from Jakiro. Jakiro throws us a little bit more of a curveball. Not really a support hero that's picked up much anymore. Really, guess most of the time these AoE teamfight combinations just stopped. That was the main reason. He's also a really good combination here if you're looking to lock down people like instantly, like not having to worry about that Lathrak stun timing. So you get the SD disruption off, and then like Ice Path throws out, so you got a guaranteed instant hit. So it works out that way. Alchemist being the fourth pickup, so we get ourselves an extra stun. Nice vacuum to an Alchemist stun, work out nicely, and then AM is the final pickup. So we got early game aggression, and we've also got late game farm and power. And also got like nice bit of mana burn, control in lanes, and Darkseer is going to hate that up on the top lane. Probably going to force out SD Jakiro as well as Alchemist to go together. And Slata's the final pickup here from Gamer Uni. Interested to know exactly who this is intended for. It's not as though we're trying to eat through anybody or trying to get on top of anybody that's got either invis or like low armor. There's nothing along those lines which we're looking to shut down. But, and we'll add him a little bit more of an AoE crush, so that combines up with the Darks here, works out with Jakiro. It's a lot of AoE stuns here, but nothing going to be 100% out there. Alright, so last hero to be played out, picked up right now from Gamer Uni, then we're all good to go and get ourselves inside the game. Let's see how our lanes are going to unfold in front of us. But we'll run through who's got what. So No Fear, he'll be our Gyro, building for a longer lane. So it's like he'll be the man that'll be supported. And again, Nubik also doing something very, very similar. It almost looks like he's built to go towards that top lane. Which means No Fear. Can go either way. Sunlight being pulled a little bit more. He'll just do it tough for the middle lane. Oh, they're going to run Keeper of the Light down here on the bottom lane. Yeah, don't know exactly why Nubik's down here, unless he feels like he should be here to scout out the jungle. But only one of these heroes will remain that's on our screen. As far as looking over to Gamer Uni, so we've got Riku, we've got Nessel, we've got Pylai Dai, as well as Darkseer. So Rocketman ready to go, and Benser just hanging back a little bit further. Sitting in a position where he can basically see deep out in this region. He can also deep in here and deep in there. That's what he's looking for. Looking for heroes to come out at him. In fact, he's going to hide inside the tree line. Are they thinking about a gank down here? Would have rotated out quickly and saw Nubik on the bottom lane. So SD will look for a disruption. If he gets one, then they can get that ice path and then chain stun out whoever they so desire. But I'll just watch him leave the lanes. Battle begins. No preparation done for the middle lane at all. Dyxia could have leveled up Vac and just destroyed off these tree lines if he so desired. Allowed for an easier pull. But that means he wouldn't have been able to Iron Shell farm. And wouldn't have been the way he wants to go. So what's the bottom lane? So it is Coddle, it is Bane, and it is Gyro. So yeah, we are going to have Animage go safe lane top. He'll go one-on-one up against the Darkseer. Not going to be the easiest lane for the Anti-Mage unless he gets really over-aggressive against the Darkseer and removes his mana. But if he tries to do that, he'll miss out on the last hits, and then nothing really works for him. And I say that because, like, you got no last hits, you can't afford to Tranquil Boots up in time. Darkseer is able to find his last hit, so he'll have Sol Ring. So as you can see, he just holds Nubik off the lane. Doesn't want to get close, doesn't want to take the damage. And the same should be said about middle lane. Like, Slaughter, while there's a melee up against a range hero, Storm Spirit shouldn't really be getting on top of this middle lane, because you got the power of SD. SD can always make a move in towards that middle lane, throw off a disruption, and then Slaughter comes in for a follow-up crush. Won't be enough to kill off Sunlight from the get-go, but if we do see SD get up to level 2, then they'll feel it. And that's probably the reason why we see the rotation coming in from the Bane. Goes Enfeeble up at level 1. So no Nightmare, but takes away a large portion of the damage here of Slaughter. So Slaughter finding last hits can be next to impossible right now. So it's down to Nestle to ensure he gets these support heroes off the lane. How's bottom lane looking as well? So we got level 2 Shark, 1 level Chakra, 1 level Luminate for the level 2 Coddle. And Chikira, all he's got to do is keep that Keeper of the Light away, but that's easier said than done. Because they're only running dual lanes down here now, it means the Keeper of the Light is going to find himself some decent levels. Already see the Flat Cat as well as Rocket Barrage, 1 point up in each for No Fear. So the burst damage is available for IC Cup on the bot lane. Searching for Chikira. Already has to use his Clarities. May as well. Keep those Illuminates flying. Chakra level 1 doesn't really give you that much mana back. Not for what you need. Middle lane. Oh, we got Disruption. Invis movement, and now Crush will be in range, but they don't really have enough damage to follow up on this. Enfeeble or not. And Catcher or not. Doesn't really have enough of a follow through. Downside about Slaughter. Until he gets more buffier and then he can start diving further. He's just not really that great a ganker in the early stages. Storm Spirit out-leveling him in the middle lane. Oh no, is he out-leveling too? Just slightly. But out-CSing is the bigger thing. 15 for 5 for Sunlight. Nanny Mage up on the top lane. Has managed to get up 14 for 4 up against the Darkseer here. Is 12 for nil. And that's what I'm talking about with being aggressive. Got Darkseer with no mana whatsoever. Forced to Sol Ring and do his stuff that way. But now he's got no mana. Nubik wants to keep going on it. And whoop, hello. There he goes, bottom lane. Should have been ready for Gyro to do that. But then again, Alchemist as well as Jakiro. Getting caught a long way out of position. Must have felt they could have initiated up on a Gyro just then. But that's some serious confidence there. Because you know how much damage a Blast can do from Coddle. Not to mention then the Barrage and the Flat Cannon. That takes away their life almost instantly. That fight could have just been over in about 2 seconds. And Darkseer in the meantime is just almost making this too easy for Nubik. He's got his Tranquil Boots up and running, so he found that amazing CS for himself. Get a couple last hits in, keep his mana low. Keep that life also tickling down. Oh, Benza. He's trying to have another crack, but he's walking straight into a Coddle Blast here, which means Flat Cannon doesn't even need it. Ice Path just keeps him out of range. Flat Cannon goes up, and then that's not going to be enough to kill him off, even with the second hit, because that blast was there. Coddle just on the edge of it. Flat Cannon attack. If the Coddle Blast hit, then Alchemist would have been dead. So just a quick call coming out from the Bane, needs a moment to himself. Probably realized that rotation came down towards the bottom lane. Observer Ward's just off to the side. Not giving vision, though. That one does. So they'll see the SD as well as the Jakira coming a little bit closer. But again, you know, Seacuff will be happy with this. Rocket Barrage comes off cooldown, but then again, there's going to be a long stun. 4 seconds, Cataplast keeps the supports away. And Pylai die, almost Ebb. Barrage, Flak. May not need it. Doesn't need it. No, he doesn't. Snipes him off on the bot. Still waiting for this middle lane to go when Animage... Oh, he is level 6. He is level 6. Won't take much for AM. All he's got to do is keep that mana low, drop the life down a little bit further, and then throw out the ultimate. Radiant's bottom tower. And he's got himself a freebie on that top. Dire's top tower is under attack. And already level 5 up on a Keeper of the Light 5 minutes in. This is so dangerous. I see Cup just moving further and further in front. Got a great mid solo, they've got a great top lane. 21 for 3 on the bottom lane up against an Alchemist who's 12 for 1. It's out CSing on every single lane. And you see Nubik doing it again. No matter whatsoever, Sol Ring or not. He wants to Iron Shell it, but Nubik just farming underneath his tower. And every time Darkseer is forced to fall back, he loses so much more. Oh, disruption. It's not going to block him in. Cotter will escape pretty easily. Yeah, but every time Darkseer moves back off this lane, he's not finding the experience. It allows the time for Nubik to find these last hits and denies. Which means Darkseer doesn't find those magical levels he needs. Oh, middle lane, that could be trouble here. It's like Sunlight's already been played around with a little bit, but then... slowing down Riku. Oh, he is diving top. Yep, there we go. AM ulti. Combination, I was trying not to miss like the double kill first blood in the bottom lane. A lot of pings coming out towards that bottom lane. Vence is calling for help down here. I don't really know what he wants to do though. What help can come in? It means a rotation out from mid, but the second you do that, you know, Storm Spirit's just going to TP himself down the bottom lane as well. We'll just couple quick jumps, do some damage to the mid tower. Vayne could rotate down towards the bottom lane again, but he's trying to stay here in the middle lane in case something like this is about to happen. Crush up on Sunlight, so he's got to get that Nightmare off. So Nightmare on one, there's already the disruption going out in the Slaughter. He's trying to be a little more cautious with Riku. And at the end of the day, Riku forced to actually sprint himself away, but because he takes more damage when he does that, that small attack of Bane is enough to kill him off. So we go 5-0 in favor of the Dire side. Well, finally get to see that creep skipping from Darkseer. Now he's got some level of regeneration. Oh man, Pensa. Is that a 4-level blast now? 3 levels on Illuminate. Damn, that's a lot of damage. You can't stand here. Even behind the tower is risky. Kotal just moves into this little position on the side. Oh, why is AM so low? Yeah, just Perseverance and then just Tranquil Boots as well. It'd be fine. Yeah, but Kotal can just stand here in this position here. And then just blast out this direction. And it'll reach basically to the edge of the tower. Or you can go off to the other side. Just all depends. It's just looking for that opening. Benster. He's going to try and find one here in the mid lane. Already with the amplified damage up on the Bane. Can't get close enough to do that. And Sunlight, he is level 6, so he'll be supporting in a very, very quick time. Yep. Nestle. Think about that middle lane. Now we get a second amplify up. So perfect vision of where the movement is in the middle lane, but they need a disruption set up. And then the crush to come almost instantly. And that's probably the reason why we're not seeing the disruption. Disconnection out of the game. So, quick pause until we get him back inside the game. Just a reminder too, guys, we will be doing more of the 4PL tonight. If you want to follow the details, this is the match we're currently casting right now, but you can just head yourself over to the 4Players website, so 4pl.4players.de. The other teams which have advanced through, and we'll be looking for a game from here in the next round. So looking towards that round of 32, or round of 16, we're doing round of 32 now. But Fnatic NA, Absolute Legends, Team Empire, looks like our Silo, SLO, has managed to come through. Details about that team. A couple of unknowns, but they'll see if they can perform well, see who they're going to be matched up against, and RoxKiss. So we've already got four really nice named teams coming into the next rounds, but everything's a best of one, so basically anything can happen with this. Our next game coming up will be coming from there. We'll have to wait and see just how far off we are. Almost through all of our matches. 3D Clan, they're playing up against Don't Waste Time. That should probably be our next game, AL up against 3D Clan. You both still got to play their game to advance through, and then they play up against Team Empire. Should be a fun matchup. Two unknown, so one of those guys will be able to get through. IC Cup and Game E, there's our game right there. 3D Max also playing up against TCM. So two teams from Star Ladder. We'll try and play into that ninth slot to go up against that SLO side which came through, so that gives us our answer there. And RoxKiss, well, probably playing up against NextKZ. I'm pretty sure it's a Risk Gaming will probably have something to say about that. And there's DD Dota, still working their way through. Power Rangers also win this competition. Baguette. We're going up against Eyes on You more than likely. That's if the French boys still play well. Those guys play a hell of a lot of Dota. All right, we're back inside the game. I see the go, I see the no, and then I see the go. All right, let's rock and rumble. So 5-0. And Bane getting some supplies in towards the middle lane. Carrying full treads there too. Is that for sunlight? Yeah. A little time taken to micro up the courier there. Trying to save the illusion rune on the bottom more than likely. Nice amplify into a crush. Gives the tranquil boots over to the keeper. The light, best thing he could have picked up then. Now blinding light too. Riku can't hit much. Picked up. Also thrown back. Doesn't matter about the blinding light. Pick him up, throw him down, another crush, and then, whoop, Alchemist done, doesn't really hit much, and now Benza, yep, gets spotted, but Nestle, fast enough, Sunlight's not going to catch up, there goes your cooldown, and a quick barrage from the high ground, there, that SD died, but it was a rotation in from, well, actually, yeah, Gyro, the kill of the Slaughter, coming up from that bottom lane. Still not strong enough to push down towers. Something both these lineups really fail at. Nice double stack. But yeah, something both these lineups really fail at is taking out these towers. Until No Fear gets a lot more farm up and running, and they can't just force down the towers early on. So a lot of this revolves around team fighting, rotation, and just getting some really good farm up. And you may be able to add some pressure towards the T1 tower in the top lane shortly. Now only a Claymore away from his Battle Fury. And this is 10 minutes in, and he bought Tranquil Boots. Some really good CS. I'm going to come in behind Darkseer. Oh, he finds Shakiro. Darkseer also doesn't have a lot of life here. Nubik, oh, good rotation. I said rotation and kills. They bring in the support, but then again at the same time, Slaughter dies in the mid. Three heroes do what four heroes did on the top. And now they'll look for more. Jara's already TP'd in. It's like he was looking to give a little bit of help here. And damn, he does a lot of damage. 4 points up in that barrage, 3 points up in flat cannon and the cooldown. So no rocket initiation. But if he starts the flak, and there you go. Nestle's already going to go down. Creep wave might even finish him off right now. Nope, 2 seconds on the stun. No real extra support coming in. Look, he's trying to get the brain sap. Can't get himself in range. Maybe he did. And Benson moves out. I was waiting for Storm Spirit to jump, but he maybe was fearing jumping blindly. That's what he ended up doing. Brain sap range probably a little bit too short. So go with the Fiend script. Ensures the kill. No, it wasn't that. He's already used Fiend script before. How must kill off the middle lane. Yeah. So it must have been Brain sap or Nightmare. Either way, cooldown 15, 14 seconds. Thought it was just a little bit less time since I clicked on him. And again, judging by his full mana. No, he attacked him. That's just normal right click. Lol. Alright, here's our push finally coming into a tier 1 tower. I said Gyro when he got a little bit more farm, but looks like they want to force out a little bit earlier. So Coddle into ulti form. Not bringing any help just yet, but with a Coddle Blast, takes care of Moses' creep wave, Barrage to ensure it too. So nothing lost to the Iron Shell damage. They just keep the power going. Whoop, Nubik. That's all, he's a long way from home. AM ulti. Oh, it's not enough. And he blinked into the ice path. 2 seconds before he can blink himself back out again. And Benz is going to have to throw the stun before that. Try to blink. Storm Spirit just wipes over the top of the SD. Oh, nice macro fire. If only he could have combined it up perfectly with the ice path. But Sunlight's got enough time to jump himself away to safety. More TP support comes in. Nubik also able to escape. Keeping the AM alive made that worth it. Especially considering they still took out the tier 1 tower on the top lane. Making it now 10 for 2. Ogre Club up on the Gyro. So more cash coming his way. And keep it light. Easily able to hold the mid. Gives mana to Anti-Mage as he runs back up high. And remember that gold on Anti-Mage. What they didn't want to have happen was that Battle Fury being delayed. Considering his cash, it has not been. Leaving it level 11, 14 minutes in. When you look over to the opposition, we've got level 8 up on Alchemist and very little farm on him. Slider level 8 also. Boots, Urn, and a Bracer. So hasn't finished up Treads, hasn't finished up the drum just yet. Oh, Storm Spirit, long jump. Quick pop in, quick pop out. Darkseer can't kill him off. Just a quick TP. Back. Reflex is just a little bit behind on that one. Walked up the hill, probably wasn't really expecting a Storm Spirit to TP out. More expecting him just to walk. But because he TP'd back to base, Cotter will recall him back in towards the middle lane and then jump in again. Try and go for the pickup. Not going to happen, but he can do jumps like that because she got 3 points up in Chakra from the Keeper of the Light. So Sunlight will always have mana. You just cannot push with Iron Shield up against Coddle. Especially once that Coddle has a level 4 Illuminant. It's just not possible. The creep wave will instantly die whenever you put an Iron Shell on it. The other thing you can hope for is to get that another team fight engagement. But IC Cup are the ones that are taking the initiative. They're moving forward. Looking for kills in the middle lane. Sunlight just wants to run, so there's our extra vision. Sees Nestle. Jumps up. Another static remnant so they can see what's going on here. Also catch it in. But when you got 4 heroes supported, there's no way that GU want to initiate on that. So they try and go for trade. Tier 1 for a tier 1 tower instead. 211. Anti-Mage doesn't really care. He's just continuously farming up and then going into Tranquils. He's waited a little bit longer for that next set of Tranquils, but that's okay. They'll go up to the tier 2 tower and farm up on top of that. While Sunlight rotates in as well. It's like an extra support coming in from the Keeper of the Light. No, actually, sorry, from the Gyro. So they need a jump from Storm. They can't see him though. Jump up now, they see him, but too late. A quick Storm pull would have done the job. But you can't win them all. Bane. I don't know really what he's trying to achieve here. Long way up by himself, looking up on the high ground. It's like, just check this region, walk into mid where there's probably only one hero here. No. So now they can push the tier 1 tower in the mid. But then again, Keeper... they can. Keeper of the Light's out of position. He's on the bottom lane and no TP scroll. So it's down to no fear to hold this lane. At the same time, Anti-Mage continues to farm up the top. And who's he bringing bottom lane? So we actually bring Sunlight, and they spot Benza. Coddle Blast already going. It's going to be a little bit too far out of range, though. They slow him down, then double TPs come in. So by initiating on the bottom lane, Gyro is capable of holding the mid. And there's already our stun. Got to jump, Sunlight. No, it's going to go over to the Keeper of the Light. He's took a mech charge up, so it's no problem. He's just making sure. Now with Storm Spirit pulling out the slider. There's no follow through with the crush, not until they get back in range of the tier 1 tower. And now it's time for the TP supports to come in from the Dire side. Blinding Light, not going to make this easy. Is there another pull? There's a Coddle Blast. Is there a jump up with the Coddle Blast? Pulling back in again. No mana. Now he does. Also, no missile. Still no missile. Even at level 10, there's still no missile. Even 1 point's worth it. Coddle Blast. He's turning around for the kill. Almost overextension. Well, Bane searching up Venser. There's support coming in. He's going to try and Fiend Script this one out. Darkseer can back and cancel it. That's why I saw Master Rock cancel it out. But then again, he's got support coming in too. Gyro's on the way. Well, Animage still continues to free farm top lane. Treads are done. 1200 up. Can we look at him just go straight into that BKB? There's a decent amount of stuns coming out from GU. Storm. Jump in the middle lane, so slows down Pylai Dai. Goes for another jump. Just trying to get on the other side of that ice path. But the cooldown's going to kill off Pylai Dai anyway. Storm was the one to get the last hit, though. So 3 to 13. Advantage. Going higher. 12,000 for the experience, as well as the gold. All going the way of IC. And then blink away to safety. Battle Fury Vlad's now up for AM. Good to see him going so early game. Battle Fury will help you with that. Denied. Battle Fury doesn't really help you with that. It was a joke. But the Vlad's does at least. Means he can move around inside the team fights on top of just farming up. Never really has to retreat back out again. I'd say it's a little bit more early game. Because he never has to go back. And because he ended up like just disassembling the Tranquil Boots, it wasn't really that much cash to do it. That means in team fights when he's attacking, he can actually get some lifesteal up. He can remain alive during the fight, as opposed to having to wait for a full BKB before he'll have the confidence to go in. So he might even see him go straight into a mana style, as opposed to waiting for the BKB and the mana style to come up before he engages. It'll all depend on the success of Gyro. If he can keep doing his thing, then Animage will have no call to come, and he'll just keep on pushing up that top lane. Looking for the top tower, he's already 152 CS in 19 minutes. Having Storm Spirit having a couple of fun jumps. Sending his illusions through. Also getting that flying vision, watching them just walk out. Slider with a crush, he could turn and fake it. Not gonna happen. With a Coddle Blast coming on the bottom lane. They just can't get in close here. Rocketman already down to 2/3 of his normal life points, so he's able to get the denial on the tower. And now Benson with a Shadow Blade. Gonna look for the stun, but cooldown turns around. 3 heroes to get caught in this with the Coddle Blast. Gyro's gotta get in closer. There goes the Jakiro. Flag cannon, not enough damage. Sunlight, maybe a secondary jump. He's looking for the courier right now. Started with a crush, not gonna let it happen. Nice back in, but Sunlight wants straight back out again. That'll pick up a double kill. Yes, one last attack round, but not enough to kill off Rocketman. And Coddle's gotta stop walking through that wall. Can let off one blast from up on the high ground, and it's going to be enough damage to help kill off Slaughter. Fiend Script held him there just long enough. Looks like we even had TPs back in. That's Nubik pushing out the middle lane. Yeah, there we go. Straight into the Yasha. He's looking at a lot more earlier game as opposed to BKB. Coddle could just keep the pressure on the bottom lane by himself. While the rest of his team does its job in the middle lane. Now Mana Leak got to go out and someone. Who's he going to pop it on? Oh, doesn't matter. Gyro is down. Slaughter might also be dead for the moment, but he'll come back in a moment. And Sunlight just trying to solo up the entire team by himself. Double kill for him. Going deeper. He already got the Jakiro before. And Slaughter comes up. Cops are called a blast. And Sunlight trying to be pulled back out of the base here. But he'd be forced to ulti himself out. Which means he needs Chakra. He needs Chakra now. Mana Leak up on the Slaughter. Too late. Archibus able to finish him off. Chakra was there at the very, very end, but it came just that little bit too late. They want to pull him out and still have a way to escape. Looks like Nestle. Yeah, there we go. Slaughter's realized that they're missing a player. So you got to pause it up for that one. Can't play without Nesty. Looks like the live streams managed to smooth itself back out again, which is very, very pleasing. As opposed to the horrible, horrible, horrible lag. So what do we got? Huge advantage for the Dire side, both experience and gold. Mass items up on everybody. Orchid now done on Storm Spirit, which is what allowed him to pop off that Jakiro before when he engaged. Starting to build into a BKB as well. And then Mech on Coddle, Arcane Boots. And that small extra bit of mana to come in from the way of Bane. It's mainly so it's got a higher mana pool. It looks like he's building into a Yule Scepter at the same time. And Gyro getting sick of that Alchemist now already. Hasn't had that Shadow Blade for long. But he's already bought up a gem back in base. And the Animage. Looks like he's about to get pulled out. Farm up on the bottom lane. He's already pushed out the top lane as far as it goes. But it'll give him his ultimate orb down here. Not enough money to finish off the full set of items just yet. Darkstreet at least has the mech up for his squad. Yeah, Roshan time. Another beautiful thing about Vlad's. Yeah, he can tank it up all the way. As long as he doesn't get bashed, he's good. And right now, Roshan can't get a bash to save his life. And there we go. Mana Style up and running. It'll fly in. He'll drop his Quelling Blade and pick up the Aegis. Unless No Fear's going to take it. No Fear is the one with the gem. Yeah. Yeah. Discussion of... Okay, so it goes to Storm. Pops him. Suppose he is the man who's the initiator. So that's fair enough. I don't really fear too much for Animage, and there is no fear for No Fear. BKB, gem, drums, tranquils. Any amount of damage he does if they come in close on him. Man, Nubik. In fact, he's over double the CS of the Gyro. And the closest one to him is 80 gold up on Bensa. I'd hate to even think what our net worth is. Almost double that of Bensa. Helps that all these towers have gone down. Oh, Storm, jump up on top. Finds Bensa out of position. Coddle can pull him back in again. Yep, there goes your ulti and recall. So this turns into a five-man fight anyway. And the Coddle blasting it very, very hard here. Ah, he's not close enough anymore. But Sunlight will jump in. Wants some new shade up here on Nestle. Then over to Bensa again. He just bought back for this one. But it's a nice AoE stun. Able to hold him out, but then in comes the BKB Fear. Nubik takes a triple kill, ultra kill, in fact, for the Anti-Mage. And they will take bottom racks, and they might even force a GG out of GU, considering they just bought back both the Alchemist as well as the Darkseer. Yep, there goes the GG. They realize they're too far behind. And we'll be jumping ourselves into our next game, and it's going to be happening very, very fast, guys. Looks like Absolute Legends are already ready to play. So we'll have AL going up against, was it Roxkiss, I think I said it was? AL versus 3D Clan. And it's AL with the stand-in. They're using Cinderin as a stand-in for now. So the picks have been done, and we will remake, or they will remake, and I'll jump ourselves into that game. So guys, we'll be back here in a moment with your next game. Stick around, we'll be back. AL versus 3D Clan coming up shortly.